The path to atheism for many people is personal and gradual. It starts with understanding the world. Things like how old is the earth, how long have humans lived, where do humans come from, how are humans different from other animals, was there life before humans, is it God who created humans, or is there another explanation? Of all the claims, which one is true? Which claims have evidence? How old is the universe? They compare the answers, see the contradiction, and come to their own conclusion. This is the sort of self-thinking they go through when they read books to understand something about this world. No one is expected to become an atheist. Every atheist claims to be a non-believer by themselves. A lack of belief in God or gods is atheism. It's not an affirmation that there is no God. Atheists can't prove that there is no God. If there is no God and you're trying to prove something that doesn't exist, it would be impossible. The burden of proof lies with someone who believes or knows there's a God. Atheists are almost certain there's no God, but not absolutely certain. The contradiction between religions and their beliefs is another reason why it is hard for one to reconcile when questioning religion. Many people are unaware of religions apart from the one in which they were raised. Islam claims Allah is the one true God, revealed by, well, Allah, through Gabriel to Muhammad. This God cannot be the Christian God, since the Christian God is composed of three indivisible essences, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. This God, again, cannot be the same as the Hindu God, which manifests into many gods such as Shiva, Vishnu, and others. All of these religions contradict each other. The teachings of each religion contradict each other as well. People who believe in these religions agree that the God they believe in is the only true God and all others are false. All these religions are fundamentally different, and this has led many theists to reconsider their beliefs, and it has also helped many come out of their religion. The difference in beliefs has also created violence and hostile treatment towards others and to those who leave their religion. Muslims are very hostile towards apostates. Ex-Muslims are people who leave their religion. Many keep their non-belief private, but some ex-Muslims speak out against fundamentalism and dogmatism in Islam. Muslim apologists who don't want others to leave Islam often claim an ex-Muslim was never a true Muslim. On the contrary, many ex-Muslims are actually well informed about Islam, and some even have fully memorized the Quran. Like Islam, Christian fundamentalism has also made many atheists speak against it. To a great extent, Christian creationism is being undermined by the scientific discovery of the theory of evolution, and its compelling evidence has made many theists leave their religion. Although there are philosophical arguments for God, there is no evidence for a God that intervenes in our lives. Islam and Christianity are both monotheistic religions with different gods that cannot be reconciled. Hindus, unlike Muslims and Christians, believe in and idol worship different gods, making Hinduism a polytheistic religion. Nonetheless, the Hindu community opposes the polytheistic viewpoint. They believe that Lord Brahma, the creator, Lord Vishnu, the preserver, and Lord Shiva, the destroyer, as well as their wives, Saraswati, Lakshmi, Parvati, and hundreds of other gods, are all aspects of one supreme God. I'm not sure if all the gods are thought to be manifestations and incarnations of the same God, or if there are other Hindu gods who exist independently of the one God's manifestation. During the COVID-19 lockdown in India, a new Hindu goddess called Corona Devi was created. A group of women from West Bengal actually worshipped Corona Devi. And when asked how this goddess looked, they said it was formless and it could be anywhere. This also happened in two other southern Indian states. They had a black stone idol consecrated to goddess Corona Devi in Tamil Nadu and they worshipped it. Similarly, in Kerala, a man named Anilan, who said that worshipping a virus was not alien, and he installed a shrine to Corona Devi. I don't know if Hindus would consider Corona Devi to be one of many manifestations of their supreme being. If they think this God that was created in the 21st century should not be considered, then I think we must be extremely skeptical about the other thousands of Hindu gods, as well as the one supreme God for whom there is no evidence.